What's up, everybody? My name is Russ Dornish. I'm a youth pastor from Montana, and we're coming at you with our daily devotions for CrossFire. CrossFire is an online faith-based community of gamers.
And my name is Pastor David Petty, and we are here with another one of our Lenten daily devotionals out of the book On the Threshold of Transformation, a book by Richard Rohr, and we are making it inclusive language for everybody. So let's dive right in with day 39. We need conditional love, too. We need both conditional and unconditional love if we are going to thrive. If we're lucky, we received a combination of both kinds of love from our parents. Experiencing unconditional love as a child gives us a strong base, a healthy, spacious sense of self. Yet we need to hear the sacred no, something to bump up against, something that creates for us a situation with limits. Otherwise, we will never go deep and discover the best in ourselves. We need both a total acceptance and a conditional demand against our natural egocentricity.
At its best, parents' love is also conditional because it teaches their child inner discipline, reasonable limits to their own ego, and an experience of their own power and skill in meeting the standards of the parent. Without it, we develop the soft and self-accommodating entitlement that characterizes so many of us. So our questions for today are, when am I best served by unconditional love, and when am I best served by conditional love? So both types of love. How are you best served, David?
I think for me, I think conditional love is important, when it's task oriented, right? If, you know, if it's, I'm going to approve of you because you did this task, you know, if I mow the lawn and I stop halfway, my family is going to come to me and say, hey dad, we love you, but like, what's going on here? You know, why is the lawn half mowed? And you know, I think that it's important to have that bumping up against the no, the healthy, spacious sense of self, because then that makes me say, okay, next time I'm going to do a better job. But I think then when it comes to who I am as a person, right, it's important to say, okay, so you failed at mowing the lawn, you failed at getting this task done, but it is, we do still love you and we do still care about you. And it's part of why we care about you that we want to make sure that you do a good job at the things that you choose to do. So what about you, Russ? And when are you best served by unconditional and conditional love?
I think a lot of this has to go back to even yesterday's question about mentoring and things like that. I think especially when you're mentoring somebody and you're trying to challenge them, conditional love is going to be a very big aspect of that. You are going to want to be able to, you know, show the appreciation and the caring and love for when they complete the tasks and the challenges that you set before them. But I think also on top of that, you also let them know frequently that, you know, your love and your caring is unconditional, that it doesn't matter if they fail or succeed, you're still going to love them as well. So it's kind of a way of rewarding in the conditional love. And then the unconditional love is more of a kind of a backup, a fallback, or so to speak, of things that you're able to give them even when they don't succeed, because nobody's perfect. So I think that's a really good use of it. But that's it for today. We are moving on to our final daily devotional during Lent. We are hitting day 40. So make sure you guys subscribe and like the YouTube page so you get notified when we upload videos. And come back for the final video tomorrow. And make sure you continue the conversation over at Facebook, CrossFire Faith and Gaming. God bless.